गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, स्टैंडर्ड 10 पीटी रिविजन्स। आई एम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम वॉलीबॉल। हाउ टू राइट द आंसर फॉर द क्वेश्चंस, यू हैव टू लर्न फर्स्ट। डोंट राइट लाइक समथिंग वॉलीबॉल हाइट फॉर मेन, डोंट राइट 243 मीटर्स, 2.43 meters. You have to write the height of the volleyball for men is 2.43 meters. You have to give that marks. Don't write without any heading, without tail. So that's why I am going to give the answer. We have to repeat and same question I'll give you. How you are writing, let me check. Class work. First, volleyball. I will go with the volleyball. So volleyball questions. Explain the following terms in volleyball. Maximum your question will be based on terms. So you have to write the correct terms. So let me give you an answer, then you follow through, everything will comes under you. Now first question is an attack hit. That means explain the following terms. From the underneath there will be a 4 questions. Each question consists of 2 marks, total 8. Section question A. That is contain total 25 marks. A question 4 will be there, B question 3 will be there, and C questions 4 will be there. The first A questions 8 points, B 3 questions, each question consists of 3 points, that is 9 point total, and C part consists of 4 questions and the outright 8 marks question answers. Now first question is attack it. All action which directs the ball towards the opponents with the exception of service and block are considered as attack it. This is the right answer you have to write on your board exams. Understood? Now second, a foot fault. A foot fault is committed when the server put his foot over the back line while serving, or when a player puts his foot over the center line into the opposition side of the court. This is called a foot fault. Third one, an ace. A serve that results directly in a point, usually when the ball hits the floor untouched on the receiving team's side of the court. This is called an ace, is a service. Fourth one, a technical timeout. Most of them are not giving only technical terms, 60 seconds, that's all. You have to write completely. Let me give the answer, you follow. It is given for 60 seconds in the final set when the leading team reached at the 8th point and 12th points. It may be requested by each team. It's called technical timeouts. Next question B. Explain the terms. That is a B question. State any 3 rules related to a libero player. Now let me read out its rules. You have to write specific rules related to libero. First point, The libero plays a special role in a team defense. Second point, the libero may not serve block or attempt to block. Third point, the libero can be neither team captain nor game captain. Fourth point, the libero player must wear a uniform whose jersey at least must contrast in color with that of the other members of the team. There is a fourth point. In that you have to write 3 points. Choice is yours. Second questions, the B sections is what is the rally point? This is important. Second question is triple block. Sorry, this is the rally point is third one. When three players take part in a block, the hands of the blockers should be raised at one time and level. It raises a white screen over the net. This is called triple block. It is a technique in volleyball. Now, third one, a rally point. A rally is the sequence of playing actions from the moment of the service hit by the server until the ball is out of play. If the serving team wins a rally, it scores a point and continues the serves. If the receiving team wins a rally, it scores a point and it must serve next. This is called rally point. Next, C questions. Answer the following. There will be a 2-2 marks question. Four questions may come. Sometimes 8 questions. 1-1 mark each questions. So I am going to write first one. Weight of the ball. You have to write weight of the ball. Then there is 260 grams to 280 grams. Don't write 260 to 280 grams. Write the weight of the ball 260 grams to 270, 280 grams. Second one, circumference of the ball. You have to write circumference of the ball 65 to 67 centimeter circumference of the ball. Next, number of players in a team. You have to write same heading, number of players in a team, 6 playing, 6 substitutes in a team. Next, they ask question, height of the net for men and women. Now, you have to write height of the net separate, height of the net men, 2.43 meter. Then you have to write height of net woman, 2.24 meter. This is the answers. Each marks consist of half mark. Now next, sixth one. How many timeouts are awarded to a team in a match? Timeouts awarded to a team. One timeout in each set and two timeouts in final set. So this is timeout awarded. Now again the question, duration of a timeout. You have to write duration of a timeout is 30 seconds. Now let me read. Duration of a timeout 30 seconds. That's it. Now, eighth one asks measurements of the free zone area. A free zone area 24 meter into 15 meter. This is the answer. Now I'll come to the basketball. Draw a neat labeled diagram of basketball court with its dimensions. You have to draw the court neatly, basketball court. You have to write length and width and center line. You have to mention the measurements, like 28 meters long and 15 meters width. The measurements, dimensions, you have to mention, draw the level diagram, you have to mention all the measurements, including center circle, restricted area under the baskets. You have to mark fully. If you have already given to you drawing, you can see in that, and as well as your see your textbook, you will get full diagram of that. Draw neatly. This question consists of 8 marks. Next question, B part. There is a 3 questions. Each question consists of 3 marks. What is a team foul? They ask for what is team foul. Team foul, the total number of fouls committed by a team during one quarter, and it is indicated by a red flag. This is called team foul. The second question is, explain the double foul in a game of basketball. Answer, double foul. A double foul is a situation in which two opponents commit personal fouls against each other at approximately the same time. That is called double foul. Next question, C questions. Held ball. Held ball, it occurs when two opponents have firmly gripped the ball and neither can gain possession without undue roughness. Now new changes has come. With new changes, a throw in is taken from nearest side or end line where the violations occur. You can write anyone. Now part C, there is a 4 questions. Sometimes they may ask 8 questions. 4 question means each question 2 marks. 8 question means each 1 marks. So C part, explain the following terms in the basketball. First they ask screening. Screening is an attempt to delay or prevent an opponent without the ball from reaching a desired position on the playing court. The players of the opposite side make a screen with their hands in such a manner that the player of the opposite cannot shoot. This is screening. Next question, a 5-second rule. You have to write 5-second rule, a 5-second rule. A player cannot hold the ball without dribbling or passing for more than 5 seconds. This is called 5-second rules. Third question is a zone press. Zone press, a position in which players are stationed in key areas. An attempt to intercept passes, traps, and put pressure on the primary pass receivers with movement out of their initial stations. So this is a zone press. The last one, a multiple foul. A multiple foul, when many players are involved in the foul like held ball. In this, jump ball is performed from the nearest circle. The new rules now, side throw or throw in from the sideline is taken in alternative manner. Because it's a multiple happen, they will take to nearest circle and between two plays, they make to jump. Nowadays, the rule has changed. Now, new rules. Now, side throw or throw in from sideline is taken in alternative manner. You can write this also and that also, no problem. Marks consist two. So, this type of question you have to, every week you have to follow. Every week I will give the video explanations, you have to follow through. Good morning class, stay safe, stay at home.